Okay, class. In last class, we had seen teachings of Jesus Christ. Then we saw what is crucifixion, resurrection. Now moving on to spread of Christianity. How Christianity spread all over the world. Okay, by its simplicity, the religion become popular all over the world. So by its simplicity, so the religion was very simple. So it become what is famous all over the world. After the death of Jesus, his disciples began to propagate this faith. So after Jesus' death, what happened? They started spreading the word. So all over his 12 disciples, they used to travel and they used to tell about Jesus Christ. So we have some of the characteristics here. First one, personality of Jesus. The simplicity of Jesus attracted common people. His appeal towards poor, sinners and sufferers and his spiritual powers helped in the spread of religion. So what a personality. Because of Jesus, personality, he was someone who can, common people would talk to or someone, okay. So because of that, his appeal towards poor. So we were talking about personality of Jesus. So because of personality of Jesus, he was someone who, when common people will be attracted to him, and also it become that appeal towards poor, sinners, sufferers. He was too good towards them, okay. So it become easy to spread the spiritual power, helped in spread of religion. Next, moving on to simple principles. Jesus principles like fraternity, compassion, forgiveness and faith in knowledge of heaven. All this made Jesus popular among the poor and slaves. So what happened? Jesus was someone who shows compassion towards everyone. He was fraternity. Fraternity means somewhere where they'll have equal opportunities. Then forgiveness, faith in the kingdom of heaven. So because of all that, it was easy for poor people and slaves to accept Jesus fast. Because they wanted someone to give them, compassion, each and everything. So it was one of the easy causes. Next is role of apostles. Okay, 12 apostles played a dominant role in spreading Christianity by popularizing the principles of Jesus Christ. So we have 12 apostles who played a prominent role in spreading the word of Jesus. Among them is Saint Peter and Saint Paul are important. So we say, Saint Peter and Saint Paul are very important. Saint Peter founded a church at Rome and become the first pope to spread Christianity in the Roman as Asia Minor. Okay, so what happened? We have right pope who's the for Roman Catholics the head. Who is there in right now? I guess in Vietnam. Venice. So in Rome. So how he is popular? So Saint Paul was the first pope. So been there. Saint Peter was executed by Nero, the emperor of Rome, which made him as a martyr. Okay. So Saint Peter was executed by Nero, the emperor of Rome. Saint Paul became the second pope. He spread Christianity in Greece, Rome, Macedonia, Athens, Philippi and Damascus. He established the churches of propaganda, the principles of Jesus. He was called the second Jesus. Okay, so Saint Paul was the one who started spreading the word of Jesus, and he was the second pope, and he spread in many countries like Greek, Rome, Athens, etc. And he was called as the second Jesus. The martyrdom inspired many like Saint Matthew, Saint Mark, Saint Luke, Saint John. They consolidated the gospel of Jesus. So what happened? Many after Saint Peter and Paul, many apostles came up like Saint Mark, Saint Matthew, Saint Luke. Then they all consolidated gospels, like the teachings of Jesus was put together and called as gospels. The effort of Saint Augustine in England, Saint Patrick's in Ireland and Saint Boniface in Germany led to the spread of Christianity. So we had in each one country who were there to spread the word of God. Among them is St. Augustine in England, St. Patrick's in Ireland and St. Bonsai in Germany. So who are the 12 disciples? It's Peter, Paul, Andrew, John, Thomas, Matthew, Mark, Luke, Judas, James, Simon and Bartholomew. Okay. And next, moving on to conviction of Christians. Christianity refused to worship the Roman Emperor as God. Okay, so Christian people refused to worship the Roman Emperor. They did not believe in divinity of Emperor. So they didn't believe that we have to worship kings or the rural. So they don't wanted to worship the Emperor. Emperors like Nero, Trajan, Marcus, Arius, Dacius and Diocletian persecuted Christians ruthlessly. So some of the ruler kings who were ruling, people who used to follow Christianity, they were killed by this kings. In 64 CE, Rome caught fire. So in 64 CE, Rome was caught fire. For the incident, Nero held Christians responsibly and massacred many Christians. So because of this reason, Roman people thought that they were the cause for the fire. So he massacred, means killed many people who were Christians. During Nero and Diocletian, thousands of them were thrown before hungry lions. In spite of this, Christianity did not suffer. Christianity preaches love for cruelty, compassion for non-compassion, So what happened? So many problems they faced, so many things they faced, but then too they didn't give up, because Christianity is something which pieces love for cruelty. So compassion for non-compassion. Rome could not destroy this religion. Instead, it accepted Christianity as the state religion. So because of this, so many things they did also, they could not, what to say, they didn't give up on the Christianity. Later, Christianity become one of the state religion of Rome. Role of church. The church become the chief institution for the preservation of propagation of the faith. So somewhere church is something where the spread of the word will be spread. People believe church as a way to heaven and Pope as a representative of the God. So people thought that church is something, the way for heaven, and Pope is someone who is a representative of the God on the earth. Despite persecution, Christianity gained popularity. If they have so many problems also, what happened? Christianity gained popularity. It become very popular. Role of Constantine. Persecution of Christians stops when Constantine become the emperor of the Rome. Okay, so when did the persecution of Christians stop? Is when Constantine become the emperor, the king. Constantine recognized Christianity. He built a new city called Constantinople and dedicated it to Virgin Mary. So Constantine is someone who built a new city called Constantinople and dedicated this place to Virgin Mary, that is Jesus mother. He gave permission to the missionaries to spread Christianity in the east. So what happened, this was then when he gave missionaries, is someone where for example you will have sisters, brothers, nuns who will come and spread the word of the God. So they got the permission to come and spread in the east part of the country, east part of the world. On the graveyard of Saint Peter at Rome, he built a Saint Peter's church. So in Saint Peter's grave we have Saint Peter's church. He issued edict of Milan 3113 CE to make Christianity legal religion Roman Empire. So he gave a, what to say, like to give a great permission or something, you should have evidence, you know, that is Christianity is a religion. That time he gave edict of Milan. He embraced Christianity publicly under the emperor Theodosius of 4th century CE. Christianity become the state religion. So when it become state religion under Theodosius rule, it becomes state religion. He also abolished the practice of paganism. Paganism is nothing, they believe in Roman and Greek people, they believe in the gods, like what to say, Jewish gods like Jupiter, sky or god, sky was a god, then Juno was worshipped, then you have Mars, Venus, love for Neptune, ocean, this all were worshipped. The nature was worshipped and planets were worshipped. So they stopped all of those when Theodosius was a king. By 5th century CE, Europe was Christianized. Rome became the seat of Pope. So by 5th century CE, Christianity was spread all over and Rome became the seat of Pope, the spiritual head of the Christian religion. Then how did Christianity come to India? Christianity in India. Christianity came to India about 2000 years ago. Saint Thomas, one of the 12 apostles, arrived in India in 78 CE. So it was Saint Thomas who had come to India in 78 CE to spread the message of Jesus and carried his work in Malabar. So he first started in Kerala, Malabar. Europe navigators who came to India in modern times for trade and commerce were also accompanied by missionaries. When Europeans had come for the trade purpose, during that time missionaries will come to spread the God's word. Mention can be made for Saint Francis Xavier, who spread the Christianity in Kerala, Goa, Tamil Nadu in 16th century. So it was Saint Francis Xavier in 16th century who spread the word of God in Kerala, Goa and Tamil Nadu. See, he built Saint Xavier's church at Goa to spread Christianity in India. So he built one church in Goa, Saint Xavier's church, to spread Christianity in India. Then sects of Christianity. Under Christianity you have many sects. So an important development that took place under the history of Christianity is Reformation movement. So when did Christianity had a, what is it, change? It was Reformation movement. So after Renaissance you have your Reformation. Renaissance is a movement where the artists, everyone had come to the seat of Italy and they started writing or doing sculpting. It was time where it was too prosperous for the literature, architecture, etc. So Reformation is where the religion was reformed. Okay, it was a religious movement within the church of Rome. So it was a movement in the church to cleanse the church of various evils. So inside church only a lot of people were, what to say, corrupted, etc. The movement was led by Martin Luther. So it was started by Martin Luther from Germany. Because of the Christianity split into two sects, because of this problem Christianity was spread into two sects, that is your Roman Catholic and your Protestants. Okay, so Roman Catholics are faithful to Pope and believe church as a gateway of heaven. So Roman Catholics are the people who think that yes, church is very important for us and church is a gateway of heaven and Pope was a representative of the God. That is what Roman Catholics think. But Protestants are Christians. As Christians oppose the evils of church and the followers of Martin Luther. So Roman Protestants are the one who will, what to say, they, what to say, they thought that church is not the one who is the gateway of the God, not the Pope, and also they all were the followers of Martin Luther's festivals. 3 days are celebrated. 3 days are celebrated as festivals by Christians. So birthday of Jesus, that is Christmas. So Christians celebrate Christmas. Then the day of crucifixion of Jesus, that is the Good Friday, and the resurrection of Jesus, that is your Easter. Okay, these are the three festivals which they celebrate. Then moving on, you have influence of Christianity. This religion gave a cultural and religious framework to Jews. Its influence has been seen in all aspects of life. So religion, this religion gave a cultural and religious framework to Jews, okay, and its influence has been seen in all aspects of life. So it gave a different aspect in the life. Christianity did not much to civilize the people. Christianity did much to civilize the people, okay? It taught the virtue of humanity. What is humanity? Tenderness. And what is mercy? It brought the ideas of fatherhood and brotherhood, fatherhood of God and brotherhood of man, how God and Father are much important, which led to the world peace and cooperation. Because of this, yes, we have to have world peace and cooperation. It stressed on dignity of labor. Sunday and special dignity of labor. So labors are much important when they do work. Yes, Sunday is a special day. Sunday and special festivals are treated as holidays. Okay, the poor, sick, disabled are receiving greater care under Christians. Large number of hospitals and education institutions were built in the same name of Jesus. Christian era began from 1 CE. Beautiful churches and cathedrals were built in Greece, Roman style. Greco-Roman style. The religion also raised the position of women. So this is how Christianity become very popular, and it spread the God, Lord's word. And the spread of Christianity, which started in in Bethlehem and Jerusalem, and spread all over the world. And how it spread all over the world, and how today it is standing as one of the dominant religion towards the world. And you have 33% to 38% total population. So Christianity is one of the important religion, and the founder of Christianity is Jesus Christ.